action. So I just played for Marilyn Soko for the two of us in this room. My instructor at West Neighborhood House is teaching me how to do it. And he's really amazing because, like, he basically knows how to make, maybe this is an overstatement, but he knows the fretboard so well, and he knows all these different chords so well, that he can just, like, without no notes, just with complete ease, just play whatever. And you like, something inside you cries out, "Oh, you played that song!" But then something holds back because you're like, "But wait, what is he playing?" And so anyways, I gave him this song. He asked me what song I wanted to learn. It's For Marlin by Soko. And we're kind of in the early stages of learning it. And as the two of us in this room know, the voice really dominates the song, and the lyrics are very powerful. Nonetheless, what I'm learning is the guitar, and maybe after I learn the guitar, I can learn the lyrics. But, you know, like, he joked to me, "All you have to do is practice this time 500, practice this 500 times. And he was joking, but he's actually right. Like, at my stage, I'm, I guess, 2 or 3 years in. This very simple progression. I just have to practice, like, you know, like, we both agreed I don't have to be, like, militant about it and be just, like, killing myself practicing the progressions, but I just wanted to show us this. So it starts with F. Then A minor, then B flat, back to F, then it there's this thing where you take a chunk of the song and you play the whole thing. In sheet music, it's like, anyways, so it goes back to the beginning from the top. How it works is you play the song the way the sheet music says, then there's a little indicator that says go back to the beginning and play it again. And so you play a certain section twice, and then you move on to the rest of the song. So here's back to the beginning, F. Now we're past that section, so we go to C, which is down here. Then we go to B flat. ways that I'm then back to the start. No, I don't know how to do the D minor. Anyways, so that will sound a lot more coherent if instead of using my finger picking, which I'm new at, I do the pick for this. I don't know how to do the D. So did that sound about right?
Yeah.
So this much easier way, or theoretically easier, I last music lesson I brought in the capo. That's what it sounds like on the fifth fret. And so, for example, you can play Love Song on the capo, and it's like an octave up. Thank you. song played with the nut. This is called the nut, and it basically no capo. Exact same fingering sounds like this. Capo back on, and I will show you the chord version. So that was Love Song by The Cure, and now I will show you the chord version of For Marlin. I guess, you know, I was playing power chords, but I was picking individual chords. I wasn't strumming them. So the For Marlin goes like this in chords that you strum.
Thank you.
is good. Seal of approval. So, just since that was depressing, as I was saying, now I'm going to action, by the way. Okay, so as I was saying, now I'm going to do Smash Mouth All-Star, which was played at the Trump inauguration by Three Doors Down. But I started practicing All-Star before I knew that happened. And now it's just so absurd that I learned this song. So it's very simple. So, no, let's do the French national anthem, Les Mouth. picture this. Elliot Smith, Between the Bars. Neighborhood version.
Thank you.
Somehow it helps that I sing along. You do not have to sing along. America's Beautiful? This song?
No.
Okay. America's Beautiful. This off.
Thank you.
thank you for watching and listening, or just listening.